everyone. So I was in the middle of getting ready. I did do my hair and I thought what better time for me to show you my skincare routine than now. So it's probably my most highly requested, you know, tutorial or video. It's the most frequently asked question, what products I do use for my skin. I don't have the best skin, but my skin is getting there. It is definitely improving and I wanted to share some of my struggles or, you know, the products that I've been using and I'm loving. So this is what my skin looks like with no makeup. I don't have anything on. I've just completely prepped my skin, which I will go through that with the rest of the video. I do have chapstick on, just the EOS little mint one that I absolutely love. But this is my everyday at home look, if you want to say. I prep my skin every single day, whether I'm going to be wearing makeup or not. So, you know, right now I'm about to go run some errands with my daughter and I'm going to get ready because I'm going out for dinner tonight with some friends. But otherwise, this is it. Like this, you know, maybe my hair would be in a bun or in a ponytail, maybe curled from the night before, but I do prep my skin every single day because I'm seeing the results that I'm really happy with. And my skin is, you know, being more radiant lately and some of the acne scarring has gone away, but I wanted to show you what my skin looks like without the makeup and hopefully show you the preparation that I do every single day and that you can take some of these tips away with you. Any of my future videos where I'm showing makeup, this is the steps that I'm gonna take beforehand. So I wanted to show you first. And if you have any questions, please make sure that you leave those down below. I'm happy to help, but I'm gonna go get ready and I'll be right back to show you the rest of the products that I use. Okay, so I'm back, I'm ready. Aubrey's still sleeping, so I'm gonna go ahead and film my skincare routine. And now I just wanna say that you don't need all of these products to have your best skin, but I would suggest three of these products that are essential that I think you should go out and buy regardless of what you're using, and I'll share that throughout. I do wanna say that I am oily skin, I'm 24, and I have several skin goals or concerns that I want to target. I can't remember the last time that I was comfortable enough to, you know, share just my skin without makeup and post a picture about it. So this is so much more than just skin, and I hope you realize that. But it has given me confidence to share my skin and share, you know, my struggles or concerns with you all. So even if you're not oily, I do suggest that you listen to the rest of the video so that you can see some of the other products that Clinique does have to offer. But if you don't have my skin type and if you're not in my age group, you can definitely go to a Clinique counter and get skin typed. They have this great tool, it's called the Skin Diagnostic Tool, which will help answer any questions you have using lifestyle questions and give you the right products that are right for you. But again, this is my skincare routine and I do this every single day and night, and some products do differentiate and I will show you that. But the first product that I use morning and night, whether I have makeup on or not, is gonna be the Clinique Take the Day Off Balm, which looks like that. I'm gonna link Patrick Star videos down below because he is hilarious, he's my favorite, and he has a really great video that shows how he uses this product. And I'm just gonna make sure this is clean. Yeah, it's clean. So this is what it looks like on the inside, and I just take a little bit of this in my hand, and what I do is I start to rub it in my hands. So with the warmth of your hands, it'll begin to emulsify, and you just rub that throughout your face, and you can see your makeup just start to break apart and disintegrate and all of that great stuff. So this is considered a pre-cleanse step, which is the first thing that you do before you cleanse. The next three items are the three essential items that I was talking to you about, and that's considered Clinique three-step, which mine looks like this. Yours may be a little different depending on your skin type. And this is what Clinique is known for, the three-step system, and it truly has changed my skin. And so for me, since I'm oily, I use the Clinique Liquid Facial Soap for Oily Skin formula, which looks like this. And you can use your hands, or if you have a Clarisonic brush or the Clinique Sonic brush, I have the Clinique Sonic brush. I just take a pump of this into that brush. It will be timed for 30 seconds. So I run that twice over my skin, but you don't have to add pressure or add any movement because the brush does everything for you. But with the Sonic movements, it allows all of the cleanser to get into your pores, get into your skin, and allow all of that dirty debris to really come up. I will say that because this is formulated for oily skin, my skin feels really clean after this. It doesn't have that excess oil, it doesn't have that shine, and I mean, I can't live without it now. I've tried several cleansers, and this is absolutely my favorite. My skin feels more radiant. So that's my cleanser. My second step, so the second step of the three step, is gonna be your clarifying lotion. So mine looks like this. It's number three for oily combination skin. And now I know this looks like a toner, but it's not. It's a liquid exfoliant. It's a clarifying lotion is what it's called. I kind of like the smell of this. I know that's kind of strange. Oh, it smells so good. I know that's weird, but I love this. So for this, this is probably one of my favorite products. I mean, I love them all, but this is probably my favorite product because I think it's what sets Clinique apart from other brands, cosmetic lines and skincare lines, because with this clarifying lotion, it helps with skin cell turnover. And if you remember from the beginning, I have acne scarring. And so this helps with the skin cell turnover. It helps bring that pigment to the surface and just take that off. I also have hormonal acne. So once a month, I just, you know, break out three or four pimples here and there. And this will help with, I don't know, but for me, whenever I pop that pimple, it starts to form like this hard skin layer over, and this really helps take that skin off. It just helps peel that skin away and start fresh. So I love this, but also I use a cotton ball and I just put a little bit on there, and I suggest that you don't go in circular motions because you don't want to add more pressure or more movement because this is going to do that for you. So instead, go up and down on your skin and make sure you just cover every area once. But you will see dead skin cells on your cotton ball, and you also might still see excess makeup still left on your skin. So without this step, you would have left makeup or dirt and oil still on your skin. So I love this one. It's gross, but it's my favorite. I don't know. I like looking at like weird stuff like that. So that is my second step. Third step is the moisturizer, which for me looks like this. This is the Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel, not lotion. So I am skin type 3, so that's why I use the gel. But this is the yellow lotion that everyone loves, but it acts as a sealant. It's gonna be a sponge for your skin. It's gonna allow your skin barrier to strengthen. And this, again, like it's a sponge, so the rest of the products that you put on your face will allow for it to absorb better. And you can combine it with any moisturizer that you have, but I'll get into what I use. But this is the third step of the three step. And then after that, I'm sure you can already tell, but I'm kind of like a hoarder, a product junkie, you name it. Like, I love to do reviews for my friends and family. And if someone says that they tried something new, like, I'm gonna go out and buy it and I wanna try it because I wanna know what's great. And because of that, I have chosen the Clinique Smart line. So the Smart line has a special technology that will allow your skin to receive those ingredients and those target goals that you have at the moment. So my skin changes monthly and seasonally, and this line will allow your skin to get the best benefits at that desired time. And so, like, for me, I mean, who doesn't want smaller pores, you know, preventative aging and hyperpigmentation? So this will do all of that. It helps with five other signs of aging. So I love the Clinique Smart line. And now with the rest of the products, the best way for me to remember which one to use is going to be from thin to thick in consistency. So the thinnest one in consistency is going to be the Clinique Smart Customer Repair Serum, which looks like that. And I just put one pump, put that in my hands, and I'll rub that upwards on my face and upwards on my neck because I don't want to bring anything else down. So that's my next step. And then, oh my gosh, I'm so like itchy because of the fan. Like, it was hot in here, and so I put the fan on, and now my hair is blowing and it's like tickling me. Weird. And okay, so the next one is the Clinique Smart Custom Eye Treatment, which looks like that. And if you're like me, I was really skeptical of eye products because I figured, you know, if I'm already using a moisturizer, why do I need a different one on my eyes? But we do have different skin on our eyes, different elasticity, different collagen, different needs. And I have seen a difference with this alone, just in those little lines. But if anything else, my makeup application is so much better with this. I am really expressive with my face, if you can't already tell. And so for me, sometimes concealer will settle into lines or the powder will settle. And so if anything else, this has helped with my makeup application because I don't have that problem anymore. It's just really smooth. So if you're not using an eye cream and you're having those problems, definitely try an eye cream first. But again, since I'm sticking with the Clinique Smart Line, this is the one that I'm using. Now my next step, this is gonna still continue to be day, so this is day. My next step is my booster moisturizer. So you're probably thinking, all right, crazy lady, you're already using moisturizer, why are you using another one? Well, this is a booster moisturizer. What that means is it's gonna add different benefits, different antioxidants, different ingredients. And so for me to remember to use two, I just describe this as like a husband and a wife. So husband is gonna be the sealant, he's gonna protect, he's gonna make sure that you're on the right track. Now wife, she's gonna be the fun one. She's gonna get you to your goal faster. She's gonna be on the target. She's hopefully on time. So this is gonna help you get to your skin goal faster. Now this is the Clinique Moisture Surge, and this is my favorite one. It's for all skin types, skin 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's good for everyone. It adds hydration, instant hydration. And you're probably thinking, well, if you're oily, why do you need hydration? Well, water and oil are two different things. And for me, I'm more combination. Like I'm oily in the T-zone, but I still have random dry spots throughout the chin area. And again, it depends on seasonal and all of that. But this just allows my skin to have just enough hydration. It's oil-free, so it's good for me. But also, even if it didn't give me, you know, that hydration back where I wouldn't have the dry skin, my makeup application is so much better after using this. And because I am expressive with my face, sometimes my makeup will settle into my lines, like my smile lines and frown lines or whatever. And it's not that they're permanent lines, it's just more expressive lines. And it's just that I'm, you know, moving around and I'm being expressive with my face. And so when I use this, people ask me, what primer did you use? Did you use a different foundation? Did you use a different powder? And really what they're trying to say is that your makeup didn't settle into your lines today. But no, honey, it's not a different primer, it's not a different foundation, it's not a different powder. It's that I remembered to use my Moisture Surge, and I love this one. It's good for all skin types. If you're gonna get a booster moisturizer, try this one. Let me know what you think, because I love it. So we're still on day. The next and final step for day is my SPF. So I use City Block Sheer Broad Spectrum SPF 25, which looks like that. And I want to show you this one because it looks tinted and it has just slight coloring, which looks like that's kind of tan. I'll put some on the back of my hand. But it's not a CC cream. It's not a BB cream because it doesn't have that coverage. And when you blend it out, you can see it doesn't add. It doesn't add any coverage, but it just gives you some radiance. So earlier, the first part of the video, when I had my skin prepped, I did have the SPF on. And that's what my skin looks like with just these products in the morning. And my mom has melasma, and so I know that that's hereditary. And I know partially the reason why melasma either increases in pigmentation is because of sun exposure. So I am trying my best to prevent that in myself. And I also put this on the back of my hand and on my neck and my chest area because I drive all around Houston for work and I can just feel that sun beating down on my hands. And so if I know that it's hereditary, I'm just trying to prevent it as much as I can. Also, if you didn't know, sun exposure can lead to different signs of aging, which include enlarged pores, sagging, fine lines, you know, lack of radiance, texture, all of those other signs of aging or skin concerns that most people have is because of sun exposure. So if you're not already using an SPF, I definitely recommend this one. I love it. I mean, truthfully, I wasn't using an SPF ever until about a year ago. So I love this, and it's making my skin feel different. It's also making my skin more even tone. And so I'm light, but I have more yellow. And with this, I am able to have the same color throughout, unless I, you know, self tan or whatever. But it's helping with the radiance, it's helping with my tone, all of that in just one simple product. So I love this one. And then my final step is gonna be Clinique Smart Night. Now, at night, I would do all of these other products, but I would take out Moisture Surge, and I would take out the SPF because I don't need that. And I would use Clinique Smart Night, which looks like this. And this is gonna be richer in consistency. And we know that our skin absorbs 80% of our products at night and only 20 during the day. So it's gonna have different benefits that you need at night. And if you don't have a budget for it, you don't have to buy another moisturizer for nighttime, but I will say that they have different benefits. So when you can, definitely go buy your night cream because they just serve different purposes. And so that is my skin routine. I know that it's a little extensive and it might seem overwhelming. I'm oily and I can still use all of these products in the daytime and put my makeup on top and my oil won't seep through. So I know that they work and that they're beneficial. And I hope that this helped you. If you have any other questions, please feel free to follow me on Instagram and ask me there. You can email me, you can subscribe and comment down below, but I hope this helped you. In all of my future videos, I'm gonna be prepping my skin with this prior, and so I'll be linking this video to those. But yeah, I hope that you enjoyed this and thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day. Bye. Ugh, it is so hot, I'm already sweating. I already know how to edit, so that probably will be my video. Awesome. Eyelash extensions are so nice, but they're just really annoying whenever they're in there and it's like, you want to get it out, but then you don't want to pull it out because then you're going to be missing an eyelash. And then you have to go back and get it filled and it's just like a process. You have to sit there. Ooh, I'm like sweaty and like excited, and here we go.